Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Microsoft's Java for Beginners series. We're going to be talking about formatting strings. Specifically, we're going to talk about converting strings, string arrays, and tokens, and some of the methods you use to do that. There's two parts for this topic. In part one, we're going to talk about the concepts, and in part two, I'm going to show you some examples. I'm going to cover different options for converting cars to strings, strings to cars, string to string arrays, and arrays to strings as well. And the reason why we're going to cover so many different formats and so many different options is because in Java, there are so many different formats and so many different options. And I'm going to present some of the most common scenarios that you'll find and how you would actually deal with them. But there are many more. Now, one of the reasons why you need to convert things and not just copy things from one to the other is because you're dealing with two different things. The car data type, first of all, is a primitive data type where data is stored directly onto Java behind the scenes with a very, very fixed size. Also, strings have a fixed size when you create them. Strings, though, are not a primitive data type. They're actually an object that you can interact with. But for both of them, cars and strings, and string arrays for that matter, when you create them, they are fixed in size and you can't change them. Once there is a slight exception with something called an Arraylist, and I'm going to show you how you can write things to Arraylist later, where you can actually add or remove elements after you've created the actual object. But for strings, cars, and string arrays, once you've created the object, you can't change it. You can't make it a different size or add or remove anything from it. You can copy it and make a new copy and change that copy when you're making it, but you can't actually change the object after creation. All right, so let's dive in some of the ways you can do this. Car to string. So taking a car, primitive data type, and converting it to a string, the easiest way to do that is just say return character to string. Character is a wrapper. It's a wrapper that actually goes around the primitive data type. So remember, car is just a single character. It's just going to copy a single character to a string object and return that string object. So let's say you want to take a string and copy it to a car. Remember, you can only copy one character of that string. So here we have the string class. There's a carAt method. In my case, it's zero. So it's going to take the first letter in the string, whatever that is. But if you specify another number here, it starts at zero and counts to the right and grabs that letter or character for you and puts it into a car. So let's say you want to create a array of cars from your string. You can use the toCarArray method. And what that's going to do is create a car array behind the scenes that, by the way, when you're working with a string object, behind the scenes internally, it's actually an array of cars, but you don't have access to that array directly. You can only interact with the object that you've created, the string. So if you want to have a car array that you need to work with or manipulate, you can do that with a toCarArray method. It's useful when you're working with a non-delimited string, so you can split the string into arrays of cars and then you can evaluate each element in that car array and decide what you want to do with it. Now, let's say instead of copying the entire string to a car array, you only want to copy part of the string to a car array. Well, that's the getCars method of the string class. Basically, there you've got four parameters. The first one is the start of the string that you want to work with, the end of the string that you want to work with, the name of the car array that you want to create, and where in that car array you want to place the elements. So if I put a 10 here, it's going to place my car array into, it's going to place my cars into the car array at 10, starting at 10. So 0 to 9 would be empty. And 10 and plus would be where my string cars would go when they're converted. There's also going to be times when you need to work with a stream. If you have another application that consumes streams, for example, and you want to take a stream from a string object, you can use the cars in the string class. And basically what that's going to do is create a new array of cars using you can use map to object to decide what you want to do with each element. Decide as the array is created if you want to include a character or not, and then toArray will actually produce the actual car array for you. All right, so that is a stream from a string into a car array. The next section here, we're going to talk about string arrays to strings. So you've got an array of strings, you need to convert it into a string. Simplest way to do that is just with the arrays class toString method, copies the entire string string array into a single string for you. But let's say you want to conditionally convert elements in the string array into that new string. The best way to do that is use string builder and append, so you can go through, evaluate each element in that string array and copy it to a string if it meets the criteria you need. Also, if you want to do things like add things to the new string that aren't part of the elements, then what you would do is use string joiner. String joiner allows for three parameters, a delimiter. It also allows for something to go at the beginning of the string and something to go at the end of the string. So when it actually builds the string, it's going to take all of the elements, put them together using whatever you specify as the delimiter. In the case of mine, I've got three semicolons. And then it's going to put in this case, a square bracket at the beginning and a square bracket at the end. All right, so let's say you are provided with a string that you need to consume in a stream. You can also use this particular method to create an array list. I mentioned that before. So strings and string arrays are fixed as soon as you create them. You can't change them once they're created. Array lists, you can. You can create an array list and then afterwards add and remove elements as you need and then convert it to a stream or a string later. This is a really simple way to do that as well. You just create a stream of string array, use a collector to join all the elements together. All right, so that is string arrays to strings. Let's talk about strings to string arrays. Easiest way is just split. So you take a string and you split it based on the delimiter that you specify in your parameters here, in this case, a comma. This would just take everything in a string and copy it into a new string array. Each element would be delimited by a comma in that new string array. Let's say you had a string that is not necessarily so well delimited. So it's not very clearly delimited. In this case, I've got two spaces that separate each element that you want to split into an array. In that case, you can say split pattern and use the pattern method and compile based on what using this as a delimiter for each new element. Well, let's say there's a scenario where you have no delimiters provided at all, and you need to figure out how you're going to split that into elements in a new array. You can use the string tokenizer class and the javautil string tokenizer must be imported into that class. All right, so that's just a real quick summary of different scenarios that you might want to use when you're converting cars, strings, and string arrays. Please do check out the next recording with some provided classes that I've created, and we're going to go through them and one by one and explain what each one does. This is part one, where we describe some of the concepts. And in part two, I'm going to show you some actual examples in action. So please do check that out as well. And also check out the other topics that we have in Microsoft's Java for Beginners series.